Cats Don't Dance. Released in 1997, Cats Don't Dance was the debut and final film from Turner Animation. Despite being the only film made by that studio, it's a great movie to be your defining one. This movie is a perfect replica of the great movie musicals from the golden age of Hollywood. That's probably because the great Gene Kelly choreographed the musical sequences in this movie. That said, the music, the film's song being composed by Randy Newman, and the score by Steve Goldstein, is top-notch, truly based on its own breed of musicals, certainly distinct from the usual Alan Menken-style musicals every animated movie was trying to clone at the time. And the animation? Well, just look at it! It looks like something that easily could have been made by Warner Brothers during the golden age of animation. The movie is just about perfect in every possible way. Unfortunately, when Turner and Warner Brothers merged as this movie was being completed, Warner Brothers inherited the movie and didn't want it. They were obligated to release it. So they dumped into theaters with very little advertising, a very scaled-back limited release, and barely pulled in $3 million. Hey, that seems like the same way they treated the Iron Giant in theaters! But don't let that stop you from trying to track down this movie. It's absolutely wonderful and well worth seeing. We have a tie between Beauty and the Beast and The Lion King. I'm sorry, I couldn't choose one or the other, so I had to choose both. But why? Can't there just be one Disney Renaissance film on this list? No. Both these movies are way too perfect for me to choose one or the other. I'll start with Beauty and the Beast. But what can you say about that movie that hasn't been said already? Everything about this movie works. The voice acting, the animation, and how can you forget any of the songs from this movie?
There must be more than this provincial life.
Just watch, I'm going to make Belle my wife.
And she knows a girl who's strange but special. A most peculiar mademoiselle. If we had anybody here, and we're upset,
will rise, tale as old as time, tune as old as song.
In case you don't know, this was the first animated movie to ever be nominated for Best Picture. It didn't win, but still, that's a great sign of how great this movie should be.
I figured it out for myself.
I think I just found a new clip to use in my reviews. Let's move on. Oh, fuck yeah, The Lion King. How can you not love this movie? It has everything Beauty and the Beast has while still making it its own style. Great animation, great music, and above all, a great story with a great message.
Remember who you are. You are my son, and the one true king.
And honestly, how can you not love Timon and Pumbaa?
Hakuna Matata, what a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. No passing praise.
It means no worries for the rest of your days.
Yeah, say it, kid.
It's our problem-free philosophy. Hakuna Matata.
Honestly, I know just about anyone who's watching this most likely seen these movies and was expecting them to be on this list. But for what they are, they're definitely great films and great worthy of being on the top five. Wallace and Gromit, The Curse of the Were-Rabbit. Not a lot of people notice, but I freaking love Aardman. Wallace and Gromit, Chicken Run, even their short films like Creature Comforts. They're consistently up there with Disney, Studio Ghibli, and Pixar as being one of the great animation studios out there. Yet, they still haven't gotten the massive acclaim they deserve. Quite due to the fact that they haven't had that many feature films. Thankfully, Wallace and Gromit's big screen adventure, after three great short films, was a pitch-perfect claymation movie. Paying homage to the werewolf movies of yesteryear, while making it its own entity, The Curse of the Were-Rabbit combined big heart with that subtle British humor that completely gets lost on American audiences, and some great character work between Wallace, Gromit, and all the great characters in the movie. You know, it's surprising for such a great movie, DreamWorks tried to tamper with this movie a lot to accommodate American audiences, like changing Wallace's actor, Peter Salas, to a bigger American name. But thankfully, Aardman got their way and was able to make a perfect movie. There's nothing left we can say about this movie besides the fact that it's...
Job well done, huh?
Number two. Number two is a Pixar movie. Which one? All of them. Okay, it might be a little unfair to list Tatter Studios' filmography as number 2 pick, but really, Pixar is without a doubt one of the most consistent film studios out there. Even their weakest films like Cars or Bug's Life are still beyond fantastic when you look at them on their own. Every film they've made is a winner in its own way. Why? Pixar does care about preservation. Every movie improves the animation style just a little bit. But on the same hand, Pixar also cares deeply about story. So many people at Pixar said, story is king. And it's very true. The visuals can't carry it completely. You need a great screenplay to go with it. I mean, did you see Green Lantern? So you may be wondering how I rank these movies. Well, we'll start from weakest to best. Okay, here we go. A Bug's Life.
You got
Cars.
I got them too.
Toy Story 2.
There is an ending to
Toy Story.
Space Ranger.
Monsters Inc.
See it through, cause you got a friend in me.
Wall-E.
You
Ratatouille.
Got a friend in me.
Toy Story 3.
First thing you gotta know about me.
Some
and the best of
the Pixar films. At the time of recording this video, Cars 2 has yet to be released. Maybe, but you know what? I'm still looking forward to it.
We'll never love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy. And as the years go by.
Roger Rabbit. This movie combines two genres that should not be put together. The general film noir-style films of the 1940s, and the wacky cartoons of the 1940s as well. And the two come together, and you'd think they were absolutely made for each other. This movie is absolutely wonderful. I mean, I love this. The acting is top-notch. The script is absolutely brilliant. While it does have little flaws in it, it can still overcome it because the characters are just so likable. And the animation. My God, the animation! You know, as a kid, I would just sit here wondering how they did half of this stuff. I mean, even now, it's still incredible. Remember, this was back in 1988, and no computers were used to animate this movie. Everything you see was hand-drawn and edited onto the live-action film. And it absolutely works! The animation was directed by Richard Williams, who also did The Thief and the Cobbler, and you can see the similarities extensively. And of course, what else is great about this movie? All the great classic cartoon cameos. I mean, will you ever see Bugs Bunny and Mickey Mouse together in the same frame ever again? I don't think so! But above all, this movie just works on so many levels. It's an innocent animated movie for kids, and it's also an interesting film noir for adults. The mystery factor is what makes it work so well, and the fact that it isn't afraid to, you know, have the occasional adult line.
I'll handle this one.
Nice booby trap.
Why, my Uncle Thumper had a problem with his probate, and he had to take these big pills and drink lots of water.
That prostate, you idiot! Probate!
What else can I say? Who Framed Roger Rabbit? It's a kid's movie in an adult movie's body, and one of the greatest movies I've ever seen, and my personal favorite animated movie.
Okay, move along. There's nothing else to see. That's all, folks. I like the sound of that. That's all, folks.
So that was the top 11 greatest animated movies. Didn't see your favorite on the list? Well, chances are I either haven't seen it or I just didn't like it. But hey, everybody else has their opinions. So, if you feel indifferent about this, feel free to say something. I don't care. I'd like to hear what you have to say. But, until next time, I'm the Nostalgia Teen. I remember it because the Nostalgia Critic doesn't.
Prostate, you idiot! Probate!